The Government Medical College Alappuzha is one of the prominent medical colleges in Kerala and holds a great history behind its conception. It was the brainchild of Sri Narayana Venkateshwara Prabhu, aka N.V. Prabhu. Setting up of Government TD Medical College or Tirumala Devaswam Medical College Alappuzha by late Sri N.V. Prabhu depicts the story of efforts and hardships undergone, backed by unflinching determination and willingness to go by listening to one's own heart. We are bringing to you the story of how a newsman turned newsmaker, the story of TD Medical College Alappuzha and its founder, Sri Narayana Venkateshwara Prabhu. The facts and concept are by Sri V. Ramachandra Prabhu and Sri V. Girish Prabhu, Topil House, Alappuzha. Documentary and narration by Dr. Ramya R. Prabhu. Former are the sons of the founder and latter the granddaughter. Sri N.V. Prabhu was a well-known journalist, true to his profession, very eminent and enthusiastic. Born as the first son of Sri Narayana Prabhu and Padmavati Prabhu on 6th February 1926 in an upper middle class family in Alappi, Topil House, a prominent family name in GSB community. He did his basic education in Alappuzha and grew up to be a well-known journalist. He had a momentous childhood, as his parents were part of India's struggle for freedom and gave up foreign goods and surrendered gold ornaments during boycott movement. The family members were ardent followers of Gandhiji, and Sri N.V. Prabhu was 2 years old when Gandhiji visited Alappuzha and their home. Sri N.V. Prabhu grew up to be a man of strong will and determination who always placed social commitment above his primary duties. He was the main driving force behind the setting up of TD Medical College Alappuzha and personally met Sri Jawaharlal Nehru, then Prime Minister, for the same. His presence was inevitable and in social, cultural and political spheres in Alappuzha. He had strong social and political connections and was a friend of almost all public figures in 60s and 70s in Kerala. Although a staunch supporter of right-wing in politics, he was a great friend of all the leading figures in both right and left wings in the union as well as the state government. Sri R. Shankar, Sri A. K. Antony, Srimati Gauriyamma, Sri T. V. Thomas, Sri Achyutanandan, Sri O. Rajagopal, Sri K. Karunakaran, and Sri Pattam Thanupillai are a very few to name, and they were his acquaintances. He was an acquaintance of late Dr. T. M. A. Pai, founder of Manipal Institutions. In early 60s, there were only 2 medical colleges in Kerala, and therefore only very few could secure medical seats on merit basis. So the most preferred choice of medical aspirants who couldn't procure seats in Kerala was Manipal. And these aspirants were paying capitation fee followed by a long wait in line for obtaining admissions. Sri N.V. Prabhu used to accompany many a few aspiring students to Manipal and was a frequent visitor to Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, during those days. On such a visit, late Sri N.V. Prabhu encountered an interesting wordy duel with Dr. T.M. A. Pai, which surprisingly served as the brain wave for laying foundation to a great idea, setting up of a medical college in Kerala. As Dr. Pai failed to admit one of the students who was the son of Sri N.V. Prabhu's friend despite promising the same. But the literal oral war with Dr. Pai really shook Sri N.V. Prabhu, and an unquenchable urge started taking life within him to set up a medical college here in Kerala, in Alleppey, his hometown, if possible. Shri N.V. Prabhu's dream of setting up a private medical college in Kerala, the first of its kind, synchronized with a favorable political situation that prevailed in Kerala in 1960s. A coalition government had assumed office under the chief ministership of late Shri Pattam Thanu Pillai, a sagacious leader known as Bhishmacharya of Kerala politics. He was a close acquaintance of Shri N.V. Prabhu. To understand the public support behind such a move, the Kerala Union of Journalists at Alleppey adopted a unanimous resolution requesting the government of Kerala to sanction a medical college in Alleppey. The resolution got unabated support from various trade associations, trade unions, political parties, and even committees of library and sports bodies. Such was the need of a medical college by the people of Alleppey due to the prevalence of many a kind of diseases along the coastal belt. The government of Kerala, especially the Minister of Health, Shri V.K. Velappan, and Home Minister, Shri P.T. Chacko, backed Shri N.V. Prabhu and expressed their views that the college would run on a capitation basis and Alleppey District Hospital would be made available for clinical training. Shri P.T. Chacko, veteran communist leader, and Shri T.V. Thomas, another great communist leader, extended their wholehearted support to this venture. The Nair community, the Christian Catholic community, etc., were willing to support Shri N.V. Prabhu, but NVP wanted the Gauda Saraswat Brahmin community to come forward for such a grand endeavor. Shri N.V. Prabhu then approached AATTD for undertaking the sponsorship of the project and asked them to back him and shoulder the responsibilities. He literally had to convince the elderly people of AATTD regarding taking up of such an immense responsibility, and it was an onerous task. Thus, finally, the TD Medical College Administrative Council was formed with the then president of Devaswam as the chairman. At that time, it was his paternal uncle. And there were five or more of the members from Devaswam committee out of 9 minimum members. But all the brain behind this grand dream was indisputably Shri N.V. Prabhu. Thus, setting up of the first private medical college in state of Kerala became a venture of the GSP community under the efficient leadership of Shri N.V. Prabhu. A lot of efforts went into fixing a suitable location for setting up of the college, and 110 acres of land were purchased at Vandanam, around 9 kilometers away from Alleppey town. The construction was started in April 1963, just after the laying of foundation stone by R. Shankar, Chief Minister of Kerala. Besides Chief Minister R. Shankar, the other dignitaries who were present during the August occasion were Shri P.S. George, Syndicate member, Shri M.P. Govindan Nair, Minister of Health, and Reverend Michael Aratukulam, Bishop of Alappuzha. In fact, a lot of people from the social, political, and cultural arena of Alappuzha attended the function and wholeheartedly extended their support for the same. The first admissions for MBBS were taken in September 1963, and the pre-medical classes were also conducted at ST College, Alappuzha. Some of the most unique events in the process was a telegram on Thursday, March 28, from Union Health Minister Srimati Sushila Nayyar, congratulating Shri N.V. Prabhu for his success and awarding a grant of Rs. 5 lakhs, which was to be collected at the earliest. Shri N.V. Prabhu's trip to collect the same was arranged by Shri R. Shankar, Shri A.M. Thomas, Union Deputy Minister, and Srimati Soundaram Ramachandran, Union Education Minister. They were all instrumental in aiding Shri N.V. Prabhu in collecting the grants. The emblem of TD Medical College, Alappuzha was designed by Shri N.V. Prabhu with the help of Shri Baby, his friend and proprietor of Model Modes, Alappuzha. And this is still the official emblem of the government TD Medical College. One of the proud and blessed moments in history of TD Medical College for GSB people was the visit of His Holiness Shri Sudhindra Tirtha Swamiji to TD Medical College in late 1960s. Shri N.V. Prabhu was an ardent follower of Swamiji, and Swamiji's visit was a remarkable event in the history of the college. While Shri N.V. Prabhu was continuously working for the welfare of the medical college, his better half, Srimati Sarojini Prabhu, was taking care of every aspect in the family, as the couple were blessed with 4 kids and she was the matriarch of the Topil family, being the eldest daughter-in-law with a family of 7 children. She was the pillar of staunch support for Shri N.V. Prabhu, and the couple were generous enough to accommodate medical students at home who had come from faraway places, even from North India, and they were cosily accommodated at Topil House in Alappi until they were admitted to hostels. Things were running smooth under the leadership of N.V. Prabhu, and odds started turning up against the college around 1966-67, with an anti-medical college syndicate group forming in the University of Kerala, which strongly influenced the government to stop advance reservations of admissions to private medical colleges. This affected the capital revenues and financial crisis broke in. This was supported by formation of some disgruntled elements in GSB community with acute jealousy and vested interest, who were unfortunately elected to TD Managing Committee in 1967. So, the management was handed over to government temporarily for a period of 5 years under a mutual agreement. But the so-mentioned delegates in TD Managing Committee wanted to auction the seats and sell them to students hailing from GSB community, which was not supported by the founder, Shri N.V. Prabhu, who was also the secretary of the TD Medical College Trust. Shri N.V. Prabhu, a man of principles, suggested to offer the seats to meritorious students of GSB community for free. But the delegations for seat auctions and thereby giving admissions to GSB students were made in Prabhu's absence against his wishes, and government did not support the idea and came out with a unilateral decision of expropriating the institution. Thus, a great man's efforts were made futile by a few gluttonous people from his own community. Otherwise, still the institute would have belonged to a minor but a well-established community in Kerala, we, the Gauda Saraswat Brahmins. The government, respecting the community and the efforts of Shri N.V. Prabhu, chose to retain the name chosen by him, Tirumala Devaswam Medical College. The whole story is depicted by Shri N.V. Prabhu himself in his article, in which he hails TD Medical College as a child of my hopes and a cherished dream come true. Various articles hailing Shri N.V. Prabhu as the founding father of the TD Medical College has been published in reputed journals and newspapers throughout the years. The Golden Jubilee celebrations held in 2013 commemorated his efforts in setting up of such a gigantic institution. Not only he was the founder of TD Medical College, but Shri N.V. Prabhu was also a famous journalist who has worked as the reporter and correspondent at The Hindu, The Economic Times and at PTI. He started an association of journalists even before the present press club was formed, and he was the vice president of Kerala Union of Working Journalists. He was the president of Ramavarma Club Alappuzha, president of the press club, Managing Trustee of Padma Narayana Prabhu Trust, etc. He coined the term snake boat for Chundan Vallam in the famous Nehru Trophy boat race, a name which is still in use today. A book by Avanti Publications, edited by Shri T. A. Matthew, titled Heroes or Stars of Kerala History, includes an article on N. V. Prabhu as an unsung hero in the history of Kerala, as he was the founding father and driving force behind setting up of the first private medical college in the state. The great soul left for heavenly abode on February 28, 2008 due to age-related sickness, leaving behind a great legacy which stands with all its pride and glory, the TD Medical College. As audacious as his father, who fondly hailed him as his fifth child. The courtesy is a Facebook page in the name of Founder TDMC Alappi and a website www.foundertdmcnvp.in, which bears the story of a great man, Sri N.V. Prabhu, and his child, TD Medical College. Thank you.